Playing.
No, it isn't.
Club.
I never let that finish.
That's why I wanted to listen to see how far it would go.
Welcome to the Circle of the Drain podcast. Yay! Jesse's back again. Okay,
we were having technical difficulties beyond our control. By the way, big shock to anybody?
No, not really.
Yeah, it's working it out.
I think it would be a shock if we didn't have technical difficulties.
By the way, no matter what studio we're in, no matter who's running what.
It's the life of podcasting. It's the life of radio.
We're here to make you forget all about that.
We are the Circling the Drain podcast. Let's do introductions very quick.
Well, first of all, friends, Romans, and relatives.
Let me hear yours because you're probably the only ones listening to us.
Pretty psyched we got the Romans in. That's good. They're coming in next week, Sean Roman and his wife and kids. They're all coming in.
I'm psyched we have ears.
Friends. I mean, who'd have thought?
How many of us have friends?
Okay, now that we've lost them.
Right. We can get back.
My name is Ira, and on National Hot Dog Day, I'm proud to introduce my friend, Hot Diggity Dog Diggity.
It's Sean Radford.
Yeah, I've been called the wiener board to the gut, but I don't hear the theme music. There it is. We're back in the game. Okay, so I was ready to guitar riff at the end of the song, but it didn't hit. Enough of that. This is Sean, as I was just introduced. And over to my left is the rose at the table, queen of herself. Just a hand. Pretty much. The hand of heels, Caroline.
Hello. I'm very happy to be here. I missed you.
And very short today.
Yes, I am.
Not only are you not wearing heels, but you lowered your chair.
So you're like right at mic level.
Which dwarf would you be?
There is. That one was between sneezy and sleepy. It depends on the time of the day. Sometimes dopey. And then of course we can always go to.
There we go. I guess you can always go to me.
Is she bashful?
Oh, I want to say that I'm not bashful.
Only because my cheeks are red all of the time.
Right. I probably would be dopey by a lot of other people's comments.
So here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, the new name of our podcast, Happy and Pretty Dopey. I like it. Happy with all this dope. What? Every show, all different. Disney would sue. No, we're fine. They stole property first. Anywho, we got a lot to talk about. Of course, we're going to do shotgun stories first. We got some new foods we're going to play, Sunshine State or Other Place. Got a special day coming up. And Josh and I are going to talk about a couple of things that happened in our week.
Yeah, sure. But again, first thing we have to do is Shotgun Stories.
Shotgun Stories. Hey, welcome back.
It's been a while. Couple weeks. Anyway, for those of you who don't know, for those of you who forgot, much like us being dopey, you probably just as dopey as we are.
Anyway, here we go.
We as a group go around the world with the wildest, craziest stories we can possibly come up with. Read them off. You, the listener, get involved on the Drain, we certainly the Drain Facebook page.
Head on over tomorrow when you see a poll on all three stories, vote on whichever story you like the best.
If you don't like any of the stories, you like one of us more than the other two, vote for them. Close your eyes and pick a story.
We need votes.
Whoever has the most votes wins three wins in a row, gets to punish the other two suckers. That's Shotgun Stories. Let's go! Okay, first, as Sean said,
we have to determine the last week we didn't have show.
Right,
so we're going back 2 weeks ago.
And the winner is...
Ooh, music.
Woo!
I believe that puts it at two? Really?
I might be.
No.
Pickles, you're going from the one that was 3 weeks ago.
Oh,
that's right. Which was Carolina, which was you. Yep, so the winner is actually...
Nope.
This is the winner from 2 weeks ago.
Take my win, goddammit. 3 weeks ago was Carolina.
Yeah.
2 weeks. So Sean...
Go ahead.
Try to steal my win.
Yeah, this story is definitely not going to be a win. I'll tell you that right now.
No, it's fairly interesting, but kind of, you know.
All right, so a college campus in Colorado was shut down the other day.
Due to a situation at hand.
Turns out it was just a little corner of the campus.
Because of a bear wandered onto the college campus.
A section of the University of Colorado Boulder campus was closed on Tuesday.
That would be like Tuesday, two weeks ago, because that's when the story started. So it was closed on Tuesday, two weeks ago, when a black bear wandered into the area, climbed a tree, and took a nap. University police issued an alert on their Twitter warning students and facility members that a bear was spotted on the campus near the southeast corner. Please do not wake in. So the campus, after warning everybody to stay out of the vicinity of said bear, contacted animal control, and they came through, tranquilized the bear, caught him when he fell out of the tree, hid him nicely, removed him nicely, and relocated him back into the woods, hopefully far enough where he won't come back. But if that tree was super comfy, he might come back for another nap, so people of Colorado, if you go to that school, be warned.
And bear with them.
Yeah, bear with them, because, you know. It's a grizzly situation.
All right. I'm thinking all you needed was the cheerleading squad going.
Go, bear, go! I just love the fact that the bear did absolutely nothing but climb a tree and take a nap. Like, straight up, there's a lot of people around here. We'll get that tree. That looks close. I'm guessing both.
Half the students didn't. I got time to go. I'm taking a nap. Imagine, I got to study for my trig exam. You're sitting under the tree and you hear something. Oh, shit. I would definitely shit in the woods. I'm going back to that school.
I mean, bears are like squirrels around here. They're all over the place.
You should just be used to them and stay away.
You wouldn't think this would be the football cheerleaders for the Chicago.
Right, Colorado Bears. Isn't there golden bears? California. Okay, this was a black bear.
He just didn't get enough coffee, taking a nap. He had finals, we understand. Okay, honey nut, go.
Okay, Carolina.
So, my story takes place in Oxfordshire.
Okay, UK.
So, a singer who married what she claims was the ghost of a Victorian soldier.
Oh, man.
Has said that they are divorced less than a year later.
No way.
Yeah. Who saw that coming?
I didn't have a ghost chance.
Okay, so the songwriter and performer who goes only by the name Brocarde said she first met devilishly handsome Eduardo when he burst into her bedroom one dark and stormy night.
I hate to tell you, I think we did this story. No, when they got married. So then I'll quickly go through it because it explains how they met.
The 40-year-old said long hair Eduardo immediately announced his love for her and later began confiding in her.
Just switch to this part over here. That ghost part is, you know, the ghost sex, amazing.
So, their love affair hit the headlines when they announced they were to marry on Halloween last year. So, Bro Carde posted a video of the ceremony on Instagram where they were seen wearing all black. Well, she was seen wearing all black.
He was seen.
Next to an empty space, right. So, however, shortly after they married, Bro Carde said that said she was angry that her husband got too drunk on their honeymoon.
Yep, I remember this.
I think it gets better, though.
That
Eduardo would become increasingly possessive and would switch between being warm and intense to threatening. After our initial meeting, Eduardo revealed more about himself to me, blah, 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 doesn't matter. Where do I want to get to? Here we go. So, the songwriter, poet, and performer also said that she was tired of Eduardo's unsettling fascination with Marilyn Monroe.
Did he get to meet her?
I mean, they play
So, she claims the soldier's crush on Marilyn Monroe began on their wedding day when he spotted her in the chapel.
Oh my goodness. Well, why did they invite her?
Hey, when you invite that ex to your wedding, and then all of a sudden everything is awkward. Not his ex, because he said he never met her.
She claims the soldier would disappear for days before returning
and weeks and months
smelling of Chanel number 5, Ravens, which was Rosie's favorite perfume. Yes. The singer said that boundaries infuriated Eduardo.
Because he can't go through them.
And he started to haunt her with the sound of screaming of a screaming baby. Brocarde says she later returned to the chapel where they married in order to exorcise him from her mind.
You don't get an exorcise. I gotta be honest, I'm so glad my multiple personalities are all nicely calm and relaxed and don't go crazy like that. I'm sorry.
Guys, we're gonna stay close to home, right? Brooklyn. There are two neighbors that are arguing over Mercury.
Mercury is a cat.
It's in retrograde. It's like Pluto. It's no longer here. The 86 Ford that I still have. Love that Mercury.
While two neighbors were standing on opposite sides of their fence in their respective homes, the cat, Mercury, who is owned by one owner, keeps going into the other neighbor's yard, because, as you know, cats do what cats want. The kitty's rightful keeper insists that the other neighbor is coaxing the feline onto his property with and I didn't write this, felonious intent.
You're keeping my cat in your yard! It's our cat!
Barks the pet parent to his neighbor, who of course is just recording the catty exchange. Again, I didn't write it. Thank you.
You're,
as he continued,
you're unreasonable people.
You're holding our cat yelled demanding,
Go into your yard and you say, Mercury,
go home, don't come into my yard anymore,
and make hand gestures as in shooing the cat away.
However, when the berated neighbor reminded the irate neighbor, the cats do not understand English,
or really comprehend hand signals,
the owner then threatened to call the cops.
But they're hissing again, I didn't write it.
Didn't end there. The annoyed cat daddy went on to then accuse his neighbor.
I believe I'm going to need the porn music for this one.
He's accusing his neighbor of luring Mercury into his neighboring yard with treats and rubs.
I just happen to have this 4 pounds of catnip. Nobody to do it with.
Ready.
Who wants a little meal mix?
Tuna.
Okay.
So does the cat eat or drink anything over there?
Oh no, never.
He then deems his foe. And starts screaming,
Cat pervert! You're a cat pervert!
Well, the man, of course, denied everything, including pursuing the pussycat.
Who doesn't want a little pussy in the yard?
While remaining off camera, the neighbor attempted to reason with the annoyed man. Listen, I can understand being angry if my cat were in your yard. But you're angry because your cat won't stay in your yard and comes to my yard. My milk brings all the cats to the yard.
That's all I can say.
The vexed animal owner then flipped his neighbor the bird.
Which, you know, that was a compliment, actually.
And yells, "We're calling the police. You're harboring our cat, jackass." Is the cat named Jackass?
That would be an interesting name for a cat. Here, Jackass.
This whole thing could have been avoided by going,
Why is Sam Jackson in your yard?
It's against the law.
It's called harboring an animal. But the bedeviled dude refused to back down.
You're making things a lot worse.
Just send my cat home.
No word on if this was resolved.
Right. Okay. So, all right. If this story was about a dog, maybe I could believe that. Like, you're keeping my dog in your yard. My dog won't stay in your yard. Because dogs listen. Dogs pay attention. Dogs like us. Cats don't give a shit. Cats hate us. Cats get brought into the house, which is then their house, and you're taking care of it. If they don't like the situation, they're going to go where they want to go. You can call the cops. You can call the ASPCA. You can call anybody you want. The cat is just going to sit there and view the bird. Be like, I'm a cat. Kiss my ass. I'm going to do what I want.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Seriously. Cats understand us perfectly. They just don't care. They hate us. And then, you know, we facilitate everything they need, and we worship them. So that's just how that works. And If this is a dog story, I totally believe it. But the guy that was complaining, calling his neighbor a cat pervert or whatever the hell, he's an idiot because he's a cat owner. Not because he owns a cat, he's an idiot. He's an idiot because he realizes cats are shit and he's going to do whatever the cat wants to do. That's all I got about cats. Yes! I love cats. Stupid people are the worst.
I was going to say, cat pervert?
No, I like to be a friend of cats.
They usually like to rub up next to you anyway.
How you do?
Just drop a hand and see what happens.
Talk to the hand. Apparently someone's trying to be the cat's meow in this whole situation.
Alright.
Alright, so Sean, tell them how they can vote.
Three shotgun stories. Come on over to the green tomorrow, and we'll see all three of these stories up. If you didn't like any of these stories, but you like one, vote for us. Close your eyes, vote for a story. Just give us as many votes as you possibly can. We need them. They're amazing. Whoever has the most votes wins. If you vote for me, I may have two wins under my belt. I got a couple of little weird punishments, but I want to know. You want to vote for Sleepy Bear? Do it to it.
I didn't even know you had a belt on.
Yeah, I am wearing a belt.
By the way, applause for Sean getting through that twice without apparently, you're all sober this week, and we apologize if you want this just to be a drinking game. We are,
Go back to last week, two weeks ago.
There you go, son of a bitch. Just to make you drink.
I've been trying to get drunk all week, and nobody's done anything. Drink, bitch!
The name of the new show. Drink, bitch.
Followed by guess that word, bitch.
Puzzles, bitch.
Bitch, guess the word.
Sean.
Yes.
You finally did something on your bucket list.
I did.
Well, about a year or so ago, New York became legal.
It's 18 years old. Cannabis is legal in New York, and it was just a matter of time before the first legal cannabis recreational dispensary opened on Broadway.
And I went there the other day. And then you go inside, and show them your ID, you get another one, and you walk around, and literally they give you a card that has a UR code on it, you scan it, it gives you their menu, and then you just proceed to serve the menu, decide what you want, all you wait online, and then you go up to set up basically, kind of like a McDonald's, and they have like four different people, and then they go out to the paperwork, they give it to somebody, and then they back mail the order back, and then in an hour, 20 minutes, it's insane.
What happened to the gentleman? What happened to the gentleman? This isn't great. What happened to the gentleman? This isn't great.
The place ain't going anywhere. It's just open. And there was a long ass line. Give it about a month and there'll be no line, and you can go every day and do whatever you want. It wasn't like it was set up at this spot open, this flea market. You don't need to be able to do it this week. The place open. It is now a reputable business.
Caroline is waiting for the drive-thru. But the amount, you can actually place orders too, and they deliver. So that's just a stepping stone, like now, when places start to open, things will be smoking on that, it will be relegated exactly the same way alcohol is.
You know what I want them to open up here? I don't know if there is one. I don't know. But when I went to, where did I go to? California. It was like a dispensary.
Give it time. Not yet here. Give it time. As time progresses, we have one open on the island. There's one just opened. I think in the Bronx, I think they said. And a spot that just opened upstate. So slowly, New York's a big state, and it'll start cropping up more places, especially if they even remotely look at this place, they're turning people away. Like, literally, they close at 8 o'clock, they stop the line. They're like, everybody, from this point on, you're getting in. Sorry, buddy, I'll be back tomorrow. Come back tomorrow. And everybody's just kind of like, all right, come back tomorrow.
Everybody else is just going.
Open a big opening. Yeah, next spot opens.
Actually, Taco Bell.
So there's that too. Location, location, location.
It was something I wanted to do ever since I heard about the internet, and finally, since New York has become part of the smarter generation, we now have it, and there it is.
It's been part more of the generation.
Well, that's fine. I don't mind.
That's tremendous. That's fine with me.
We've been saying taxes forever.
Solve the problem.
Don't bother me, none. Here you go. I'm going to get into something I probably see if I got one of their stronger strains.
The other day, I was going somewhere where I hadn't been before, so I was using my GPS. I didn't charge my phone.
It died in the middle, and I said, okay, I'm going to pull over.
I'm going to pull over behind a Carvel. They have their little parking lot. So I put in my charger. I went, well, now I got to wait for five minutes while I get anything.
So I'm just looking out the window.
And then I see it.
There's a squirrel.
And the squirrel has the top of one of the Carvel things.
By the way, They must have had strawberries.
Because it was red all around his neck.
It was definitely not blood.
Poor guy. And I watched when, well, there's something you don't see.
And I can't take a picture.
Why didn't you record it?
So I'm watching as he goes to climb a tree. And he can't because of his neck. And he's going up and he's falling off.
And then he's coming toward me and I'm thinking, I want to help you.
But I'm not going to get bit.
And he's coming directly toward my car.
I raise those windows.
Don't see a tree going on this person. Sorry. Can't see you. You're not here.
Yeah, the people come up to you on the side of the car.
Hi. I need money for, well, you know, Burger King's hiring right there.
Hi. What's it called?
Blinders. Tunnel vision. Especially when someone's trying to cut me off. I don't know which one of us is going in there. There you go. Thank you.
What's something we've always been told, especially about the hot weather?
What do you have to do constantly?
Two things people tell you.
Okay.
Three things. Labor Day.
Is it Labor Day?
Drink water.
Oh, we have a winner. Ladies and gentlemen.
They hydrated themselves.
Right.
Well, I have a story here. Let's see what happens. When you have your water, but a little too much.
Oh, no. Wow. There we go.
I know the feeling of it happening, but I know the feeling of drinking too much at a beach.
Hold on. Do I not have the story anymore? Oh, I have it. Dateline, South Carolina.
Ray Jordan, 10 years old, playing outside during the 4th of July weekend, just recently.
Running outside with his cousin.
Firework! Oh, wait, sorry. Go away. Wait, hold on, I can turn off this mic.
They were full throttle running circles around the house, just a bunch of boys together, jumping trampoline and playing around as you did when you were 10. That's according to Ray's mom, Stacy.
Ray had gone in South Carolina.
Ray, get ready to drink.
Ray had gone in and gotten himself some water. What we didn't realize was how much water he got.
Noting that he drank six bottles in one hour.
By 10:30,
Ray could not control his head or arms or anything in his body. I just realized I'm not even on camera.
He couldn't control the camera either.
According to Jeff, the boy's dad, he almost seemed like he was on drugs, drunk, or even mentally handicapped. Can you say that?
It's South Carolina, so I'm sure that they don't know that.
The parents rushed their son to the children's hospital after running several tests. Doctors revealed they treated Ray for water intoxication.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's what happens when your sodium levels in your blood go.
Right.
The result when the kidneys are overwhelmed by the amount of water coming into the body. So your body pretty much, you're drunk.
Right.
You're pretty much drunk. They were giving him something to help him urinate as much as possible.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure he could fill a swimming pool without it.
Get those fluids out of him because there was swelling around his brain.
From that much water?
That's why his head was hurting so much. The doctors also spent eight hours giving him sodium and potassium to regulate his
Happy 4th of July, everybody!
There you go.
Yeah, he was seeing fireworks already.
That's going to be a story for years.
Oh my God. Hey, remember when you were 10? Yeah, that was a fun time.
Still paying. I was going to say that. Now the story is going to be.
Why are you drinking so much water? Do you remember what happened to Ray? Ray was 8.
10.
10. 10. He drunk himself stupid.
Because that's what it'll be.
He just woke up in the hospital
and he was like, yeah, I'm hungry.
Can I have a hot dog?
Right. Where am I, by the way? What the hell happened?
Stacy recalled, Ray has made a full recovery, has no lingering symptoms.
Doctor Trump, and for anybody, it could have been worse
if they didn't treat him.
Doctors noted the importance of alternating water with sports drinks like Gatorade on hot days
because the electrolytes don't dilute in your bloodstream. So, the more you know, Gatorade tastes good. Are you going to go into the water boy and say water sucks?
Nah, I just enjoy Gatorade. It's really good. It's good room temperature.
It's
amazing if you freeze it.
Take a brand new unopened bottle of Gatorade, toss it in the freezer, come back 2 hours later and thank me.
It's awesome. So good.
Anyway, I actually had a friend who was straight edge and threw a house party one time. He played drinking games with everybody, and he was drinking water, and he sucked at all the drinking games, so he got violently ill.
And then what are you supposed to give somebody who's been throwing up all night from drinking?
You give them water.
This week,
I witnessed myself
because I had to pick up some baked goods.
Right.
And I witnessed a family coming to pick up a birthday cake for their 25-year-old son. And I said, can I take a look? And I'm going to put pictures up online. Let me lower that a little bit.
Thank you.
So apparently it was going to be a dual birthday party. And one kid was into running track, and the other kid was into playing basketball.
Cake Chick made a beautiful cake on a basketball court
with a track outside of it. And from what I hear, it tasted amazing. So that's what we're trying to tell you. Cake Chick gives you cakes and cupcakes
That's what you want. You don't go to a store and you go, well, you remember, you look through the little book.
Right. Yeah. And you go, this is what we can do.
Right. Yeah.
You can do anything you want.
You want somebody to scribble out a name on a handwriting sheet? Who's Pam? Why is Pam? Ruins more relationships that way. Oh my god, yeah. So what you want to do is you want to go to Instagram
and you type in cakechick1217, or you can go to facebook.com/cakechick and take a look at all the amazing and tasty cakes and cupcakes that she makes. And you get whatever you want. I need gluten-free.
Got it. I need fat-free.
I need someone's allergic to nuts.
That's really weird.
Sure, no problem.
whatever you want, whatever you need.
So it's going to look good.
It's going to taste good.
And now, let's save you some money.
Yeah, totally.
Who doesn't mind some money?
Let's give you a promo code of three letters. CTD.
Ooh, that's easy. And if you give that promo code, you get 20%.
20%! Oh my god! We're giving it away!
Right. So again, go to Instagram, cakechick1217, or Facebook, cakechick.com/cakechick, and you take a look at I am cakechick, give her a week's notice. You tell her what you want, and you're going to get what you want. It's going to taste good. You're going to get a good price, and you won't be sorry. Now back to the show.
Already getting in progress. We're almost going to hit the whole open door.
I couldn't see the timer. Okay.
Wait, ruin it.
Damn it. Don't hit the tagline. Worst promo ever. Already in progress.
This promo's over.
Anybody know what 2 days from today is?
2 days from today, Friday.
And the date, the 22nd, 48th day of June. Sex toys, August 5th. What? Never mind, it's the 21st.
You are correct. And it's also National Junk Food Day.
Oh man, I went over some things that we've done in the past.
Oh, here's the most popular junk food in each place. I then found an article. Does anybody know how some of these candies got their name? You ever look at a whatchamacallit and go, what? Why do you call it that?
I don't actually have whatchamacallit on this list.
Okay, I got one. First one on this list. Who can tell me why they're called milk duds?
Milk duds because they're milk duds.
They were a failed chocolate milk line.
And they somehow turned into candy. Duds, I have no idea.
Pickles, yes.
Is it something with movie theaters and milk?
No. Thank goodness for that.
In 1926, F. Hoff, I love when you can just go, call me F. My friends call me the Hoff, but you can call me F.
F. Hoff.
In 1926, F. Hawken and Company set out to make perfectly round chocolate-covered caramels. But their manufacturing equipment didn't work that way. What came out were oval-shaped chocolate-covered caramels.
A worker then said, they're not working.
They're duds.
Everyone went, well, they still taste good.
Duds. Not chocolate, duds.
Simple enough?
Yep. Simple.
Okay. Who can tell me why it's called a Snickers bar?
Snickers bar?
Because someone tried to make something that looked like a Milky Way, which is a ton better, and then they snickered at it.
Wait. First of all,
what? So many wrong things in that.
There were so many. First of all, in what world is a Milky Way?
Hold on. Well, basically, you start off with Snickers. Take away the peanuts, you have the Milky Way. Take away the caramel, you have the three musketeers. So it just downgrades to worse and worse. However, the name of Snickers, somebody thought it was funny when it came out. So they went Snickers.
The neighbor's cat?
Yeah, totally. The other neighbor on the other side of the street was looking at Bob Neighbor yelling about cat. And started laughing. And then his wife was like, that's a great name for Chocobo.
Unfortunately, no. Carolina?
Snickers. Why do they call it Snickers? I have no idea.
Okay, pickles?
Well, I gave you my answer.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Am I supposed to be Milky Way? Guess what?
Sean is actually close.
When Franklin Morris needed a name for his new candy bar that would follow his wildly successful Milky Way, but better.
It doesn't say Milky Way, but better. He turned to the family stables and named it after the family's prize horse, Snickers.
So they named it after, right.
So we're all eating horses.
The effect is.
There we go.
Junior Mints! It's a Junior Mints!
Okay, because it didn't come out the size that it was supposed to. So, Junior Mint.
They were just gonna make regular mint.
Right, but that didn't work.
Sean, they were trying for bigger mints, and they just couldn't step up to the plate of Junior Mints.
Nope. Pickles?
It involved the surgery and something getting stuffed.
Oh my god, he's going to Seinfeld again.
Because Junior invented the mint.
Right. Again, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Arnold Schwarzenegger's character from 1994 decided to invent something.
Senior was late to work that day. So Junior got to get the mint. Dad missed out.
Mr. and Mrs. Mint just had a baby and went.
Junior, oh my god.
Why is he covered in chocolate? I don't mean that the way it's.
James Welch named the chocolate covered mini creams after his favorite Broadway play, Junior Mints.
A play on words, James the Junior Mints.
I hate plays on words.
Nobody was ever going to get that.
Right, no, not even. Yeah.
You have to know that answer to be able to answer. Do you like Junior Mints? Did he name it after his favorite song?
Favorite baseball player? Is that a guy? No. Having a problem with Joe. That was a stumble and a stammer and a drink. Well, Sean, how did they name Tootsie Rolls? Because somebody had a small dog named Tootsie. And that's what his poops looked like.
So we're going to need more food after your dog's poop.
Yes, a big joke on the world. I'm not going to tell anybody, but I'm naming my candy after my dog's poop. By the way, it tastes delicious.
It looks amazing.
Right.
But unfortunately, not.
A Tootsie Roll. How did it get its name? By the way, I think those things are freaking disgusting.
They have different flavors.
They're all nasty. A Tootsie Roll. Because the guy... No, I don't know. I was going to say because the guy who invented it, but why does it have to be a guy? It could be a female. So the female that invented it was like, you know what?
Hey, why don't you get those games and roll right over here? I'm going to name a candy after you. Maybe we'll go see Junior Mints right after the whole show is done. 1950s!
The only thing I would say is possibly there was like a lot of chocolate in a factory and then they made it into rolls because they thought it was the best way to do it and it was made by Dustin Hoffman.
Okay.
I don't know.
Leo Hirschfield, the inventor of the candy, named it after his 5-year-old daughter Clara, who he called Tootsie.
She's close.
I like the dog. I'm gonna say those three letters stand for something. Please eat this now! One at a time! From a cartoon face!
Welcome to the candy room!
You just lift the head and pull out the piece! By the way, we didn't even have the tools. Bring that boy over here! Lift his head!
We wanted to approve the children, though. So what do you want? Do you want Kermit the Frog?
I've got Fozzie Bear!
Whoa!
Look! It's your father!
We got little orphan Annie!
Well, she's off of something, right?
We have this cat here for you!
Why are you wearing the cat, pervert?
Carolina.
What does Pez stand for? People ejecting...
I can do as many impersonations as I want because I don't do them very well. Occasionally one just pops out and it's like, hey, this is working. I think you're all ignoring the obvious.
Pickles eating this.
Pickles, what do you think?
I said exactly that. Pickles eating
sis. Okay.
Pez was a breath mint for smokers.
Now where Sean was close is... You had the German part down.
Oh, man. Look at that.
Because the name refers to...
And I have to do the accent, which is German for peppermint. That sounds terrifying.
And the first Pez dispensers were called box regulars.
And they were supposed to be like cigarette lighters, and came with notes encouraging smokers to quit.
And how did that become kids' candy? In the 1950s, they said the same thing: change it to fruity flavors and market toward kids. Once they hooked up Kermit the Frog, they're like, we can just use your head, this is great.
Why do you keep wanting to take Kermit's head back? Because you lift their head back.
The Pez dispensers, that's how it works.
What's a little sickening for the first person to go, hey, what's this?
Rip his head off!
I, to be honest, as a child, I didn't have the patience to try and lift those things. I would just, I'd be like, I would open the damn thing and be like, and then I'd try and hold it, I'd get like one in and it just wouldn't work, I'd just throw the whole thing in my mouth. Ah, sugar!
My daughter, if she still has them, a long time ago when she was like 8 or something, they sold a pack of Disney princesses.
And I have them all, and they're still in the box. But I gave them to her, so who knows? And two years ago, they came out with the Harry Potter. Well, my friends actually bought me a Reese's Pieces. I have the last one, and I wonder if you can figure this out, because it's not that hard. Is it Twix?
The candy is Twix.
Twix.
Sean. Twix. Has nothing to do with wrong music.
Really, just so tired of all these people playing all these Twix. There's two for me and none for you. I don't know.
Because twins mated and they wanted to do a play on words, so they went with Twix.
Yeah, there was a play called Twix. My favorite rock song from 1928. Pickles.
I'm guessing that they were going to try to make one candy bar. It accidentally became two candy bars. And since the movie Twins was already out in 1987, another movie with Arnold Schwarzenegger as a reference on the show tonight, that's how Twix came about.
The meaning behind the name isn't common knowledge, but apparently it's short for twin sticks.
So it had nothing to do with Arnold Schwarzenegger. But everything else, there's somehow a reference to an Arnold Schwarzenegger film. I think I should get credit. Why not? Take it. Sure, why not? Carolina wins with one point.
Yay! Oh, you get to lift your neck. No, you lift my neck and you pull joints out. There you go. Wait a minute. That is not what I was looking for, but okay. Sean, next week is Shark Week. It is one of your favorite. But this week, there's something else that you mentioned you'd like to do, right?
They had the running of the bulls in Spain. That goes on for a while. It goes on for a while. Well, I have everything we need to know about that. Good. And the Arches date back centuries and reflect the historic practice of moving the bulls from the field outside the city where they were bred to the bull ring.
And if you pull on the horn, junior, I don't want those Tootsie Rolls. Those are the bad ones. After the stampede, the bulls have been led into the bull ring where they are typically made to run from one end of the arena to the other, tiring them out. Because in their kill by a matador, it makes it easier to kill. The animal is part. So everybody in the arena can be like, man, get that bull dance. You know, hey, thumbs up. Yeah, that's the one that survives. Let's leave Sparky alone. Yeah, America's Got Talent.
You keep that bull to the side. He was able to board nine people and three families.
I wonder if they should put electronics signs on them. Animal rights activists from PETA, of course, campaigned against the tradition before the festival. They dressed themselves in red cloaks and horns, which to me, what's that? Perfect balls to take.
That's fine. Okay, you're going to dress like a bull when the bulls come at. Be sure to get right in the middle of the crowd as best as possible, because we're depending on you.
Why do they do that?
Because they wear red.
Because they can.
Because everybody else is wearing white.
Okay.
No, it's a good cause.
It is.
Totally.
However, they're not that bright.
I don't get it. Bulls go after the color red.
This week we're gonna sing sharks. We're gonna jump the waters. We're gonna jump into the shark. And then when the sharks come, we're gonna go, bad shark, go that way. Why are they biting us? I don't understand.
Yeah, that was a smart idea about 4 years ago for everybody on the shark week to go free diving. Yeah, Guy Fieri almost got you by a shark.
Well, let's see if I can answer some of your questions.
Yeah, everybody was no cages for some reason. I don't know if they could find cages. And literally, like, Guy Fieri swimming with his son and a couple of shark experts. And you hear one guy go, hey, guy, watch back! Watch out! He turns around and shark's like,
guys, sacrifice your son and keep swimming!
Yeah, anyway.
If you just lift up his head and get some peppermint.
The Runtings plays from July 7th to the 14th.
It takes place at 8 in the morning after the line at the coffee shop must be insane for that. You're not participating?
At 8 in the morning?
If it was later,
maybe I would go to watch. But I'm not doing that anymore.
The average run is 3 minutes and 55 seconds.
Okay. I can't even run for 30 seconds.
Okay.
The average man can run about 10, 15 miles per hour?
Yeah, so the bull gets up to 24.
Oh, really? So they got two legs and about 200 pounds on you.
How many people run this? On weekdays, 2,000. On weekends, 3,500.
What are you doing this weekend, Bob? Oh, you're going to Chicago? Going to see the Bulls with Michael Jordan, that guy?
Totally. Nope, going to Spain.
Going to Spain? Is that where the Bulls are playing? Wait a minute, I don't understand.
I'm going to run with the Bulls.
I'm actually going to run with the Bulls from the Bulls.
In case anybody doesn't know, there was a raw basketball. Must have been the Heat. I would say the Bulls. I'm not very good at sports, so I give this basketball team very quickly. Just say Bears, you'll be wrong, but it's okay. That's all right, I was about to say it was a Rocky situation. It's like they're taking the Pistons away and they're trying to get away from it. How many people would you say are injured a year?
All of them, hopefully. How many people are injured a year? 200.
I was going to say 150.
Okay, I guess 400.
400. Sean is closest. It's about 250 to 300.
I heard there weren't as many injuries this year as normal. 35 lives lost, total 14.
But the last person gored to death was 95.
The bull was on steroids then. I mean, enhancements was made.
He died. Oh, sorry. I'm just floating up on top of this high school study that I used to be friends with. I'm like, well, Horcher ass called me stupid. We got some new foods. I have a feeling you're not going to be hungry after this.
I got four different things coming out.
Let's talk about first in Brazil.
Barbie fever is in full swing because of the movie, not just in the U.S., but around the world. In the lead up to the much anticipated Barbie movie, There are several trends that are taking off, and Burger King is getting in on it in Brazil. They have the limited edition BK Barbie combo. The meal includes a pink burger, Ken's potatoes, which I always thought Barbie kept in her purse anyway, and dessert. The pink burger is a burger patty with a slice of melted cheddar cheese.
Right.
An incredible smoky pink sauce that looks like Pepto Bismol.
Oh, okay.
I thought they were undercooking it.
And they were like, "Yeah, as pink as possible."
That's when you get home and you go, yeah, totally.
And then you just puke up Barbie all over the place.
It's topped with crispy diced bacon, all between brioche buns. Ken's potatoes are just potatoes in an attractive container.
What? Okay. That's sexist right there, by the way.
Like French fries or like roast potatoes?
Regular French fries. Okay. For dessert, there is a Barbie donut shake of vanilla ice cream and strawberry Nesquik blended to millennial pink drink topped with a pink donut.
A millennial pink drink? Oh, God.
Okay.
Right. So who's up for Barbie?
Not awful. Can you try it at least?
I was all for it until I realized that the Ken Potatoes is like a mountain of mashed potatoes sculpted in the face of what's his face, Ryan Gosling. Now, if I'm getting Ryan Gosling's statue made out of mashed potatoes that I can eat, I'm still not gonna get it. That makes it better. That's not even changed my thought. That's kind of like Ryan Gosling. Well, jacket on him.
Who loves extra cheese on a burger?
Take it a little bit. I mean, you know, cheese is cheese. Well, if you do, you go to Burger King in Thailand. There you can get the real cheeseburger.
It is a sandwich with just 20 slices of American cheese between a bun.
Oh, yeah, I don't like cheese.
Who wants a McCheesy?
What do they do? Sprinkle a little bit of hamburger on top of it? Nothing. No garnish. Nothing. Just bread and cheese.
I don't want fake McDonald's cheese on my Burger King burger and just in a big set.
No, I'm out.
Here's even the worst part.
You don't even grill it?
Well, that's just according to the promotional images. They show a grilled cheese.
But customers are going to social media just going,
I got a monstrosity.
Oh, sorry, Taiwan. I have a monstrosity of a cold stack of cheese.
Also, it's supposed to be a grilled cheese. It's not. It's just.
Here you go.
20 slices of cheese.
Oh, it's a Burger King cheese sandwich. Like, what?
I could literally make this when I was 10 years old.
You get the last hamburger bun that's been sitting in the bag. You take a whole bunch of crap and you just rip those parts and stack them up, and then you eat it because you're not putting anything on it. Taiwan, look what I made. I made lunch for myself. Mom, I work at Burger King. Hostess, they are bringing together two of their signature snack cakes and combining them.
When you took a Twinkie, how much cheese? Please don't. A crafty? Combining it into a crafty? When you took a Twinkie and pink sauce and put it together. Wait till you get to the last one.
You haven't lived until you've had a cheddar stuffed Twinkie.
I have Twinkies mashed up with Ding Dong.
Okay.
Okay,
okay, so it's the Twinkie sponge cake,
right?
The creamy filling from the Twinkie, but covered in fudge, like the Ding Dong.
Okay.
In other words, congratulations, you've just created a chocodile, which you already produced.
Yeah, basically. Yeah, basically. Yeah, except you're using other things.
People are dumb. Not all of them know that existed.
That might be the only item on the list that I'll eat.
Right.
Social media users have a lot to say about a Taiwanese restaurant.
When they put up shared images of their latest dish named Godzilla Ramen.
It is a large bowl of ramen.
Okay.
With a huge crocodile leg appearing to crawl out of the broth.
I've seen the picture.
It's an entire crocodile arm.
Like a real crocodile arm. I'm not eating that.
Oh come on! How many am I supposed to cut through it? It's fighting like a chicken leg on top of something. A live chicken leg? You know, it's not a live crocodile. You're not fist fighting it in the ball of ramen. Wait!
However, depending on the size of the ramen, I mean, swimming pool full of broth, throw a crocodile on one end, and then the other. Throw a bowl, we've got the whole thing, we've got the pink sauce, I got these chopsticks, watch out. We're gonna keep going, what the hell, a few slices of cheese.
Okay, we talk a lot about generations.
We talk a lot about the millennials and the now alphas.
Alpha is the youngest now.
Oh, there's always another group every 15 years. And Gen X, how overly pretentiously stupid is this one? No, it's not.
The whole group, the alphas, where are they going to be? They're not offended by anything, they just don't like colors.
Write that down somewhere. Write that down. I'll make a mental note and then be offended by it. So the alphas are coming out. Nobody can use purple. What? It's a color. I don't know. I don't know what's E. You are millennial. What is after millennial? Gen Z. And after Gen Z is Alpha. Who's Gen X? Gen X is the people older than us.
Gen X, depending on who's, it's 1980. So you're out of the board. No, you're Gen X. Yeah, you are Gen X. Okay. For this purpose, the millennials are always saying, okay, boomer. It's always the millennials versus the boomer. We were out of it, we were fine. Well, no, because now,
as time passes, generations change how they view technology and social interaction based on the world around you. And these viewpoints may be opposite, but sometimes, with a little age and wisdom, you may agree. So someone put out a thread on BuzzFeed just called Hey Millennials. I'm with the boomers on this one.
What are the things that boomers turned out to be right about?
So let's see if the millennials in the room agree, boomers are right about this. The music in some restaurants is just too damn loud.
No, I think the music in clubs and bars are too damn loud. Well, I guess Caroline is not on that boat, so yeah.
You're not, you like it.
Jump on it.
Well, not...
Yes.
At a restaurant. I guess, you know what it was? I went to a restaurant slash lounge, and I'm like, why is the music so fucking loud? I'm not at a club. I'm not at a club. I can't talk to the person.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Right next to me, let alone across the table from me. And I didn't like
the other thing I want to know is, I understand at night they want it to be a little more intimate, like mood lighting.
But when you have to take out your phone to look at the damn menu, besides, like you said,
I want to have a conversation.
But how many jackasses are walking around the world with headphones in all the time?
Does that really make a difference? What I do is I'll put my earphones on, my earbuds on, and I don't have to listen to anything, but I'll just have them on the store because I don't want no one fucking talking to me. Don't interrupt me. That's right.
Not even Fernando, by the way. That's why she's got the giant bed now, so he'll be on the other side. She calls him up. You okay?
Good. Listen, the other day he fell asleep on the couch. I didn't even fucking know he didn't come to bed. Okay, next one.
Kids shouldn't be spending so much time on their screens. Kids should be outside playing more.
By the way, thanks for listening to the show. Turn yourself on. And, hey, put on your earbuds when you're in a restaurant. Turn the volume up and make everybody around you listen to it. I see more and more kids are riding their bikes in place. Thank goodness. I always yell outside the window, hey, Stranger Things kid, what are you doing? Here's one I can really get behind. I agree with this one. Drink. Sorry, I'm so used to listening to the show that every time I curse, I'm going to drink. By the way, I can't fucking stop.
Join us next week when we'll turn to cocaine.
We don't advocate drugs. We joke around about it a lot. Drugs are hilarious. But other than that, how did cocaine get into the different? Did you guys hear that show? They all coke. That's what it sounds like. I don't know.
I think the show will go a lot faster and more organized than we can.
What? You told me you wanted to talk already? Oh my god!
Pet dogs don't belong in shops, restaurants, or other places.
No.
Leave them at home.
Sorry. Don't deal with it.
What?
What?
Are you agreeing or not agreeing?
I am not agreeing. Deal with it.
The show. No, I understand. Pet dogs don't belong in shops, restaurants, or other places of business.
Leave them at home.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're not service dogs. They're not there for any specific reason. If you're not injured, if you're not debilitated, if you need the dog for help, no.
If you're allergic, what are you going to do? I'm allergic. You're bringing your dog. Now I have to leave.
If it is a pet, I mean, if it's a store for pets, then why can't I bring my dog? You want to bring the dog to the pet store? That's fine, but you want to bring the dog out of the goddamn supermarket? No, the amount of times I used to go home, the amount of times I was literally at the fist fight somebody at the bookstore because they had a dog, and I can't bring a dog in. It's not a service dog. That's the rule. Oh, well, she's fine. She doesn't do anything to anybody. Man, your dog just bit her kid. Could you get the hell out of the store? Actually, I would say...
I realize you can't bring the dog out, but I was hoping the dog maybe would have a winner. I was thinking, why did Sean get in a fist fight with a dog?
No, the old lady. Let me tell you.
I was not expecting that.
It was possible.
It was just my side.
Right in the face.
Sean's going to disagree.
All right.
Me being mad at the neighbors popping fireworks after 10 p.m. on a work night.
Right. No, it's work night, and it's not 4th of July or New Year's Eve. What if it's the 4th of July?
All bets are off.
You know, wait until the fans and then start complaining.
You can't bitch on that day.
It's the 4th of July.
After 10 o'clock the next day, I have to wake up and go to work.
Sucks to be you. You should have taken the next day off. It's July 4th.
You should have taken the next day off.
Exactly.
Carolina?
If it's July 4th, go ahead. After 10 o'clock? If it is July 4th, after 10 o'clock, I'm okay.
After midnight, shut that shit off.
It's July 5th.
Stop.
By the way,
how am
I
going
to find them? I see the lights a mile away.
Get out the drone, find him.
If it's any other regular Wednesday, I'm fucking coming out and cursing you the fuck out, turning that shit off. I am not that type of person. I'm not getting involved in anything unless you're being a dick with fireworks on July 19th.
Three years ago, it was terrible. It's like, hey, it's 4th of July, everybody was home three years ago. Well, that's true. Everybody were caged animals at that point.
So much so that they were literally like, I got these broken candles, let's fire them at each other in the living room.
Bound them outside.
Right.
We're going to kill the COVID with the rats.
Suck in all this firework smoke. I've heard it helps. Hey, people, get me a plastic straw. Thank you. Get the paper straws. I don't know why. Maybe it's just me. I think a drink tastes different through a paper straw. It's not good. I don't go to that Wendy's anymore.
I can't deal with their paper straws. I go to the other one, the plastic ones. I will drink out of a paper straw for like the first minute. After that, no.
After that, you're going to take a little. Try and sip one of those cups. I hope you don't wet your pants because they're now cold. Pickle, tune in next week. We'll be talking about more cups. Never. Wrong time. Concert should start on time. Absolutely.
I got somewhere to go the next day. Goddamn.
Well, you should preempt and realize that you're going to have a long night ahead. You can take the next day off.
My God, how many days off do you have? Listen, I don't have any freaking days off.
I don't do anything, so I don't take days off.
So, what you need to do
you drinking?
Usually when you have something happening on Tuesday, might as well take Monday and Wednesday off and all 3 days go for it.
Because you need to get ready for it, then do the shit, and then kind of soak it in.
Totally.
Cops can start whenever they want. It's fine. You're there to see it as long as you get to see it for the prolonged amount of time.
If somebody takes an hour to get on stage, but winds up doing a blistering hour-and-a-half performance show, I might agree with you on that.
Listen, I don't...
As far as worrying about what you gotta do tomorrow, because you're here now, screw that.
You're here now, you should have...
Exactly.
Guys, I think we should all take the day off.
I need it. And what would you name those?
Salty.
Welcome to the new show.
Salty nuts.
You know, I don't.
Salty drink. Oh, sorry. Salty.
No.
I don't mind a concert starting late, right, as long as you don't have me sitting there bored out of my mind for 2 hours because I'm gonna smoke all the joints I brought for the concert.
She's like popcorn at the movies.
Yeah. But you know, as long as you bring someone out, you know, to entertain us while you take your tours, I'm fine. I'm okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, it turns out Daddy Yankee has been drinking too much listening to the Circling the Drain podcast, and we'll be delayed 20 minutes. Thank you, Carolina.
We got some famous ass fans.
Gasoline.
I would have started a fucking riot if you didn't come out.
Right?
Not the one I would have picked either.
Which one are we picking?
We're playing this one. Excuse me, sir. Here we go. That one.
Okay.
It's been a while. I had more stuff, but we don't have more time. Although, we could do more stuff, but then we'd have to take tomorrow off.
We can do this until 9 p.m.
I went to sleep, I woke up, they're still going! And I got a drink again!
You have not lived until you're half asleep listening to this podcast, and then you just hear
drink. Wake up, take a shot, and sleep like
it's the worst 2 a.m. ever.
I have this half bottle of vodka.
Now I have a quarter bottle of vodka.
Yeah, hello, boss? Yeah, I can't come in today. What? No, I'm not on a podcast. I just listened to it.
Tell us how it all started.
It started with the Circling the Drain podcast. 7:20. I was going so well, and then Carolina started talking.
Alright, so moving on. Starting out.
I want to thank governors. Oh, you have something?
I got one other thing. Hold on before we're thanking anybody. Anything in the corner?
Wait, hold on. In my corner.
Did you write anything down?
I understood the drugs, the cakes, the candy, the cake chicks.
Sniff, 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 sni
Yo! We gotta wrap this up. Do we? Okay. I want to thank the Governor Studio for letting us do this. Because nobody else would. What else do I want to thank? I want to thank Pickles.
Yes.
So go to youtube.com/cocaine. I mean youtube.com/circlingthedrain. That's what it is.
Don't put your cocaine down the drain. Don't promote the cocaine YouTube page. They already have enough fans as it is. I heard it's a very fashionable drug.
We're going to have a lot of different things in there. We're going to have the show. We're going to have little skits. We're going to have punishments when we get a chance to put them up.
And the world puts them up. Wait a minute. Now.
Oh, sorry.
You can see the old punishments.
See the old punishments. So go to youtube.com. Enjoy, like, subscribe.
Exactly.
Go to our Instagram page, which is Circling the Drain. Right?
Yes.
Circling the Drain. It's been like 3 weeks. I post pictures of crack. And if you want to check out mine, it is the Queen of Heels.
Caroline's post pictures of rocks.
We got a Facebook group page. That was almost a stop. What a drink!
We have a
passed out 2 seconds ago.
All right, here we go. So
we got this group page on Facebook where we throw up all the quick questions and the stories for the shotguns and stuff. When you see the poll tomorrow, a few days later, vote as many times as you see that poll. We need votes, whereas votes win 3 wins in a row. Punish the other 2 suckers. I got one under my belt. Let's make it 2, possibly 3, and we'll see what kind of punishment we can dole out.
But
when it's all said and done, the Shot Podcast can download all over the place. We have a whole buttload of podcasts you can be downloaded.
All those places you can download this one are. I don't know why you keep asking, because it's just Google it! You're going to see our faces in a thing of water and a jar of pickles and
a microphone. And be like, Circling the Drain Podcast. And then wait a second, that's not the show I'm looking for.
And when you find us on any social media, all of them, soon to be on Threads.
Yes.
You have to like, rate, review, subscribe. You know what to do.
Yeah, you're an old pro. We got faith in you.
Remember to go to KickKick. And how do you get there? You go to Instagram.com/KickKick1217. Or you can go to Instagram. I'm sorry. Facebook.com/KickKick.com. No, just KickKick.org.
We're trying to get the message out there.
Basically, you remember to use promo code
CTD
and you get 20% off. And they will not deliver drugs because we're not saying
nope.
So,
Not that.
Bye.